Could I tell you this? I want you to keep in mind there's a principle in film called intermittent motion, in which 24 frames a second gives the illusion of actual fluid motion. Now you're looking at one frame or in video field, which is similar, of an object that is traveling so fast that that object on one frame is making loops of light, the immense amount of G-force. No living being, there, unless that we've, and this is back in the 40s that we've taken pictures of this, so unless that we've developed a technology to isolate gravity, which is part of G-force, in the capsule of a ship, and separate it, that this has to be something outside of our world. And it would be stupid to say that out of all the billions of galaxies and planets that we are alone, it would be dumb to say that.
Yes, it would be. I would assume that you wouldn't want to lower our social, the way we look. I mean, if we start looking like primitive, living like animals again, because we don't have any food, we're going to fight with each other. Do you really think you want the neighborhood from outside of our world to really see what's going on out here with the wars, with all everything else? See, we take for granted that the other civilizations might stop by here. This might be their vacation spot. You see what I'm saying? And the more we pollute it, and the more we do bad to the planet's going to try to save itself anyway. And whoever the onlookers are going to say, oh, look at this. You know, it's just like bugs. Like the abduction. How many people played with a bug and, like, did all kinds of weird things to bugs? We might be bugs to them. And that's why you do get people get abducted. They get scientifically, messed with, and it's just like what we do when people, when they're kids, they do the same thing to bugs.
I think that there's a reason legitimately why the Defense Department is spending 51% of our combined treasury, that there really is an alien threat. Ronald Reagan tried to loosen this up in 1987 before a UN General Assembly speech. I've seen video that has been released and then he disappears about, like something obviously this man made, the space shuttle put out, it shows like reports like a rocket engine, and then it would shoot like missiles and it would clip one of these saucers. It was like, I caught that back in 95.
Wow.
And there is a concern of that.
All I have to say, Shane, so instead of worrying about the economy and all this kind of crap, I mean, why are you going to hide? The public's ready for it. You put enough sci-fi movies out there, and we have enough sci-fi movies. Everybody's ready for what's going to happen. Now, there's only two points. Either the governments are afraid that they're going to lose power because the aliens are going to come and save the people who are being treated wrong and also leave the planet. Mm-hmm. That might be one thing, right?
Anything's possible.
It could be that. It could be they could be hostile. I don't care what anyone says. They could be hostile. On top of everything else, it could be good ones like Nordics or something. I was hearing all these different stories about Nordics and the reptilians, and you have all these reports. I myself, when I was 12, I looked out the window. I thought it was my friend, but it wasn't back in 1968. I yelled out the window, "Hey, Sylvia!" and jumped over the fence. But that was way before sightings and all that. I mean, actually, in one of those, Miles Ferguson book. I guess he put me in there as an anonymous person. But, okay, so you have the world is coming, there's a planet coming, there's a pole shift coming, the economy's crapping out. I mean, you got all these different ways. Maybe there's going to be war, nuclear war, something. You see what I'm saying? We're at the breaking point no matter what it is, but something is going to happen. So why don't we get our heads together and just try to figure out, not just to save the richest people in the world and put some seeds. You know what I mean? They're putting seeds away. Why don't the hell you start building like bunkers and have like drills in case there is like a tsunami 1,000 feet? You got the Phobos asteroid coming also. There's like 8 different ways.
And I respect your opinion. And let me just say this, that I don't know about all this other stuff. I don't know. Anything is possible. But I will say this, that Word of God says that before the cataclysm and the preemptive rise of this Antichrist that would rule the whole world, there would be great turmoils in the world. And this is what my faith propagates. The only two politicians that our establishment has given us, there's one thing that has deeply disturbed me, that, you know, that one of them has made a mockery out of the Holy Bible. And McCain, of course, doesn't have the backbone to say, you know, to stand behind the church. You know, I don't know really what alternative that there is anymore other than to come out of this system and live separately from it, you know. And it is really not going to last. It is going to fall. We are going to head into a depression. These banks are closing.
Like Rome, like Egypt. How are we any different from Egypt, Rome, Atlantis? You see what I'm saying? How are we any different? We've had our heyday, and we better figure something else out.
The American empire is coming to an end.
Well, not necessarily, but it's not going to be totally globalized either. I know that.
I don't know. I'm a pro-American.
It's going to be alienized. Yeah. We're going to probably have a bunch of aliens come down. Why don't we run, I guess the show's almost over, so why don't we run the last Larry King thing all the way out, and maybe you can roll the credits over it, I don't know, with the soundtrack going, or I don't know if you can do that, if it would get in the way of the credits, but if you could do that, that's fine. Well, let's have Larry King take us out. Thank you so much for being on my show. Thank you for having me, your guest.
I appreciate it very much. Right. What a great show.
I hope we got through to some people. We will be here again, I think it's next month. I'm not sure when, but I'll try to advertise better. All right, you guys have a good night. Take care. Maybe I'll put this on YouTube so you can watch the rest of it.
Shane Devins on YouTube, too. S-H-A-N-E-D.
Bill?
I don't think they're ready. I think there would be shock. But I think eventually we'd accept it. I think that part of there is a gradual disclosure going on. I think through science fiction movies, I think through a number of outlets, there is disclosure going on, and I think that is preparing us for what we will eventually come to see as we have people out there that are extraterrestrials, and they're here.
Ted, what do you think? How do you think people would react?
Well, you know, I think I can only base that on the people I've met in the research we've done for the show. And it's just amazing how many people we've come across in our interviews and our case studies who I get to talk to who feel like they've either seen something themselves or a close family member has. It's astonished me at just how prevalent this is in not just American society, but we're over in England over there as well and worldwide. So it seems like people, a lot of people think about it, a lot of people believe they may have seen something, and I disagree with Bill. I think people would be ready to hear the truth.
Pat.
Whatever that truth is.
It sounds to me like people are ready. They've had these UFO experiences. They're not having any kind of meltdown. They're able to discuss these experiences with us. And it seems like we're an intelligent species enough to fathom that we are not alone. And I think we can handle it.
So no panic, whatever it is.
Well, I've talked to a lot of people about it, with people who've studied this much longer than I have, and there are theories that that people would panic, this would adversely affect the economy, that there would be mayhem in the streets, but I don't know. From the people we're meeting and talking to, people are okay with it.
Bill, we have a short time left. Do you think most people believe there is life elsewhere?
Yes, they do. In fact, I think that in CNN's own poll, 85% of those who responded said that they did believe there was life elsewhere. Whether that life is now here is another story, but they did believe that. I think our government believes that. I think Seth Shostak believes that with SETI. So I think that anybody you speak to would be very arrogant to say there is no other life in the universe. The question is, has that life come here? We believe it has.
Thank you all very much.